5 in 5. 5 barriers in mathematics that we need to disrupt and dismantle. Barrier number 1. The educator holds all the knowledge.
As educators, we often believe that we hold all the knowledge and learning to be shared in math. Our identity, power, and privilege impacts the way we perceive the world, interpret the curriculum, and interact with learners. When we use our power to reinforce dominant, Eurocentric worldviews without including other cultural perspectives and ways of knowing, we cultivate environments that further marginalize groups, such as Black and Indigenous communities. Sharing authority in the classroom recognizes that educators, students, and community members share valuable knowledge that contribute to math understanding, and thus there are times when we as the educator are the learner.
Barrier number 2. Math and the math curriculum are neutral.
Math and the math curriculum are not neutral. What is valued as mathematical, who is given credit for mathematical knowledge, and how that mathematical knowledge is shared within the curriculum does not reflect global contributions to mathematics. For example, when we teach concepts like Pythagorean theorem and exclude recognition of Babylon, Egypt, India, and China, whose civilizations uncover this relationship centuries prior, we uphold a colonial worldview to the exclusion and oppression of others. When educators learn and embed the history and perspectives of other civilizations and cultures, this provides a richer and more inclusive understanding of mathematics while nurturing positive affirming views of all students and their communities.
Barrier number 3. The only thing students know about math is what we teach them in school.
Students do not come to school as blank slates or empty buckets to be filled with knowledge. They all have funds of knowledge that have been cultivated by their families and communities, which are assets to math learning. When educators ignore or dismiss math thinking that is shared from home and insist on colonial methods as the proper mathematical techniques, students feel that their ways of knowing and home knowledge is incorrect or unacceptable. Center students as sense makers and encourage learners to use and connect home knowledge to classroom experiences, so all students have a meaningful entry point to access math learning and families are honored as partners in education.
Barrier number 4. Math is about performance.
Classes where students are passive learners and where getting the right answer is valued creates stressful spaces and leads to disengagement for some students. When the majority of assessments take the form of products, this practice advantages some learners over others. Creating classroom environments that invite students to construct their understanding by exploring, collaborating, reflecting, conjecturing, and making mistakes promotes learning for all students. Use assessment to empower learners. Instead of grading or quantifying every task to rank and sort students, collect triangulated evidence that captures the richest picture of student learning.
Barrier number 5. There are math people and non-math people.
When educators hold deficit views of students and do not see all students as capable learners, this leads to formal and informal streaming of students. Research shows that certain groups are overrepresented in the underachievement of mathematics, which leads to limited secondary and post-secondary opportunities. All students have funds of knowledge and deserve an educator who holds high expectations and is committed to their success. When math learning is relevant to students, respects their lived experiences, and empowers them to address social justice issues, students are affirmed as capable and confident learners and will develop a positive math identity.